warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Very good morning to everybody and salam satu Malaysia. Basically, this paper was supposed to be sent this level. However, she sends her warmest regards. She feels so sorry she couldn't make it today. I'm not the experts of this, but I tried to deliver as best as I could whatever she has prepared for all of you. Okay, for the topic for today is green neighborhood development design guidance. The presentation's outline is an introduction to what is a neighborhood and so on. Policies related to green neighborhood in Malaysia, green neighborhood concepts, good practice, and the benefits of promoting green neighborhoods. Green neighborhood guidelines are currently that JPPG is producing a guidelines called green neighborhood guidelines, where a few of the contents is actually touches on the smart location, green neighborhood patterns and design, green infrastructure, and also green communities network. I'm sorry that I have to read her presentations because I just got it this morning. However, I hope that you can bear with me in these 30 minutes of this presentation. Okay. The first speaker has touched on GDI, and the next the second speaker already touched on how we can construct a building using recycled materials and all. But I would like to recall back on the first presentation that whatever we name green, sustainable, is all the same terminology. Nowadays, people are talking about low carbon city, low carbon society, which aim to a sustainable vision. So, at the Bristol Accord, put up sustainable neighborhood means that it's a mixed use area with a close knit community where people live, work now, in the future. Whereby I realized that it's also a cyber city. Was also putting on the work, play, and what you call your terminology just now is work, play, and live. It's accordance with that. So sustainable neighborhood meets the diverse needs of existing and future residents. They are sensitive to the environment and contribute to high quality of life. They are safe and inclusive, well-planned, built and run, and offer equality of opportunity and good services to all. A green development, I think Dr. Hathaway quoted it from Wikipedia. A green development is a land use planning concept that includes consideration of community-wide original environmental implications of development, as well as site-specific green building concept. This includes city planning, environmental planning, architecture, and community building. Therefore, land use development that has incorporated all implemented green elements in physical planning, basically was introduced by Sir Edward Howard in 1898 through the concept of Garden City. So from the Garden City concept, it expands to green neighborhood concepts. So basically, there was no specific policy related to green neighborhood currently. However, there are a few initiatives that going towards green neighborhood policies in Malaysia. GN stands for green neighborhood, which are directly related to green neighborhood at national, such as national physical plan, and also national urbanization policy and ninth nation plan. The National Physical Plan and National Organization Policy was prepared by Jabatan Rancangan Badan Desa, which I work. So this is document on the National Physical Plan I was talking about. It emphasized a few regarding green neighborhood policies, which touches on, firstly, on transit-oriented development, where the measures will walkway linkages shall be provided in order to connect the railway stations and other major landmarks or development in town centres. Second one is all urban settlements shall be serviced by integrated network on solid waste disposal and all recovery facilities. The third one is the strategic assess electricity generation plants and distribution. Mains shall be suitable located to provide reliable, efficient supply of power consumers. So it stressed on renewable energy such as energy from solar, wind, wave and biomass should be promoted to complement traditional power generation sources. Dr. Dahlia has highlighted 9 concepts of green neighborhood concepts. There are many related studies that best practice describes the concept of green neighborhood, which firstly is the highly diverse, which means people at many different stages of life may live in the same neighborhood, coming and going at different times. A broad mix of housing types, institutions, shops, offices, and other businesses makes it possible for the green neighborhoods to be alive. Second one is moderately dense. In order to reduce main negative impacts of suburban living, traffic, example, traffic congestions and associations, the green neighborhoods accommodate more people while maintaining a comfortable human scale. And then, of course, it's designed for people, where public spaces are highly valued and designed to be highly functional and enjoyable and safe. The fourth one is that destinations are easy to access because nowadays, when we look at our current development, the long blocks and widely spaced streets discourage people from walking. We are reluctant to walk even in 5 to 10 minutes because of our weather one. Another one is, I think it's not our lifestyle yet. But when promoting green neighborhood concepts, the community has to change their lifestyle. As the Mr. Dave talked about just now, there are a lot of initiatives that we can take in changing our lifestyle by using different types of materials in our clothes, our buildings. What we eat also is nowadays people are promoting less meats and less seafoods because we want to save the resources for our next generations. So if in green neighborhood concepts, they promote green neighborhoods have 5 green networks of streets and green corridors that make it easy to access destination within and around the green neighborhoods. So short distance to transit, access to regional destination is secured through fast, convenient transit service, past and through the neighborhoods. The sixth is green network. A system of green element is integrated to the neighborhood from landscaping on each parcel to the street trees and broad network to green paths, green spaces. This element works together to produce wide range of environmental benefits. Next is the green buildings, which was elaborated on the first presentation, which are highly performance building, minimize environmental impacts. I would like to this is Chiyoda City in Tokyo, whereby this city was being a regenerated city in 1960s, and there are a few one of the initiatives taken by the Japanese government, sophisticated building energy countermeasures, and also human and urban development through regional cooperations between the governments and also the private sectors. Majority of the buildings are using recycle waste after they dismantled the whole area, and 98% of the building are using recycle waste materials after dismantling the area.